بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد وكان المطر قيضا The weather patterns will be extremely abnormal شديد الحر So there'll be extreme heat and rain supposed to bring produce And they should be through the rains, growth and production. But qayd is the contrary to this. So let me explain that is shiddatul harri. That is where there are extreme heat conditions. And scientists have mentioned the inception of global turmoil through this increase in heat. Why? Because there'll be a change in precipitation. And if you look at about approximately a billion of the world's population live in areas where the supply demands run on glaciers, seasonal snow melt. As the world warms up, more precipitation will fall and all the structures will break down. So several reports have been prepared by researchers and even policy makers. That is talking about 2008. There is a prediction that in the next few decades, climate change will be a significant cause of political instability. So the emergence of this fitna, this warning, is not just coincidence, but we find that the words وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ The words of Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam will always remain true no matter what the appearance seems. And through this, water shortages may create international tensions, may create wars. People will be fighting over water. And currently now in the Middle East, there's a lot of tension over water rights. And US military officials have prepared a panel and a team. And the idea is to secure strategic points. Many big companies, businesses, forward thinkers are looking at water resources for the future. So even if you look at the international refugee status, it's because of forced displacement. Even the UN has said that it is a cause of armed clashes. And they've cited Darfur, 300,000 lives have been lost. So, hot days may get hotter, wet days may get wetter. In hot days where they're not supposed to see rain, you'll see rain. On cold days where you're not supposed to see rain, you'll see rain and vice versa. Heightening an increase of flood risks. Let's just take the example for the USA. 2019, flood waters overwhelmed many towns and caused billions of dollars of infrastructure and crop damage. Then we had all the downpours, the state of emergencies, the mudslides, and thousands of buildings and structures destroyed. So thus extreme rain events have really devastated communities locally, nationally, internationally. And we've seen a frequency and we've seen a severity of these occurrences and events, and they are getting worse. So the downpours have increased, have become more heavier, and as the 70% of the planet's surface is made up of water and the world is warming, more water is evaporating. And every 1 degree Fahrenheit of rise in temperature makes the atmosphere have 4% more water vapor. So now floods are often happening in rainiest day, and scientists have collated data of 244 cities, and they found that rainfall extremes have intensified as the climate has warmed. And amongst 80 cities, the rainfall is very disproportionate. The rainfall pattern is completely abnormal, and there's been a surge. So we've taken data from 1950, from 1920, 70%, 78% of the data shows this. And 35% of the cities have rainfall records since 1990. So taking the data from the last century, we see that more cities have observed more storms, more rainfall, more risk of flooding, more erratic weather patterns. Then we've got drought on one area, we've got heat on the other area, we've got erratic rainfall on the other side, and that's causing devastating effects on humanity. So this is a Zahiri Asbab, obviously, but we need to check our amal and turn more to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a locality, a city, a town can protect themselves if they're doing the amal of Nubuwa. So crop failure, depletion in water supplies, wildfires, droughts, disasters, the list is endless. So extreme weather patterns, وَكَانَ الْمَتَرُ قَيْضًا, your weather patterns, your rainfall will be completely abnormal. Another sign which Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has warned us, مِنْ اِقْتِرَابِ السَّعَةِ اِيَرَ الْهِلَالِ قَبَلًا, amongst the signs of Qiyamah is where the new moon will look bigger. So when we see the crescent of the moon, and it'll look like it's one night, فَيُقَالْ لَيْلَتَيْنِ, people say, no, this is a two-night-old moon. Ibn Athir has explained this, and he said when the crescent moon is witnessed, that people will presume it to be two nights old. So when he's seen the sighting of the moon, it is one day old. مِنْ اِقْتِرَابِ السَّعَةِ انْتِفَاخِ الْأَهِلَّةِ, amongst the sign of Qiyamah being close is the swelling of the moon. يَرَى الْهِلَالِ لَيْلَةِ, people will see it on the first night, but يُقَال لَيْلَتَيْنِ. So that is there. Now, if we look at the moon, Allah has put power in His unseen system where there's a gravitational pull which causes tides across the Earth's water. And the moon is approximately 384,400 kilometers away. So between the size of the moon and the Earth, if we look at it, if we had to make the Earth hollow, we would fit 50 moons inside it. And if we look at the sun, look at the qudrat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we were to make the sun hollow, for us it's just a ball of fire in the air. But it would hold approximately 64.3 million moons. And that also, the sun is just a star. It's not a massive or regarded as a big star. So the entire system of the world, the universe, gravitates according to the amal of insan. And we need to be checking our amal. So recently, researchers, when inspecting the moon, found a strange crack on the moon's surface, and this crack is expanding. So Allah knows best the origin of the crack, and Allah knows best the conclusion of this crack, and what's the true knowledge behind it. One scenario. Secondly is, there's a thing called moon illusion. So when the moon appears in the horizon, it appears larger. So it's perceived to be physically greater. So scientists have got no consensus, and recent research, a book has been written in 1989, The Moon Illusion. It's about 24 chapters, and there's different scenarios and theories which researchers have gone through. But another book, The Mystery of the Moon Illusion, conclusion is no single theory has emerged victorious. And they're saying that the size of the illusion is variable from an increase in diameter, about 50% increase in size. But scientists cannot definitely give a reason for this. And if we look now, also recently, we'll see that this phenomena is visible. وَمَنْ أَسْتَقَلْ Who can be more truth than Allah? Who can be more genuine than Allah and His Rasul? وَمَنْ أَسْتَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلَ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَدِيثًا Another sign of the closeness of the hour in Hadith of Jibreel, in a riwayat in Muslim, وَأَنْ تَرَى الْحُفَّاتَ الْعُرَاتَ الْعَالَةَ رِعَاءَ الشَّاءِ يَتَطَاوَلُونَ فِي الْبُنْيَانِ You'll see the barefoot, naked, destitute shepherds competing in the construction of lofty buildings, high rise and skyscrapers. وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ الْحُفَاتَ الْعُرَاتَ السُّمَّ الْبُقْمِ So, you will see these people, these shepherds who are literally deaf and dumb, means they've got no real potential of knowledge, of faculties of understanding. مُلُوك الْأَرْضِ And you will see them the leaders of the earth. فَذَاكَ مِنْ أَشْرَاتِهَا Then that's the sign of Qiyamah. And another sign, فَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ مَكَّةَ كَدْ بُعِجَتْ كَضَائِمْ When you will see in مَكَّةُ الْمُكَرَّمَةِ tunnels, وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ الْبِنَاءِ يَعَلُو رُؤُوسَ الْجِبَالِ And when you will see mountains surpassing superseding, it will be structures. So when structures will supersede and surpass the mountains. And the riwayat of Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As, when he was sitting in the masjid, and he said, إِذَا رَأَيْتَ When you will see in Makkah, قَدْ عَلَتْ أَخْشَبَيْهَا That the structures will be big and they will surpass the mountains. وَفَجَّرَتْ بُطُونُهَا أَنْهَارًا And you will see streams flowing. فَقَدْ أَزِفَ الْأَمْرُ Remember, Qiyamah is close. Let us combine all these points. If you look at tunnels in Makkah, there are around 58 tunnels. Remember, as time goes by, tunnels may increase. Length of 30 kilometers, and there are around 67,000 fluorescent lights, 600 fans, 42 generators. And we've been warned about the tunnels. Another tunnel is a tunnel from Makkah to Taif, which has been constructed, 11 kilometer tunnel, two parallel tunnels, each with three lanes. And at a cost of around $500 million. So that's the tunnels. Then the structures. So the second most expensive building on Earth, which was $15 billion, and that's the Abraj Al Bayt, or better known as the Royal Clock Tower, which is at a height of 601 meters and 120 floors. So one may wonder, what is the first? That is obviously Masjidul Haram, the most expensive structure in the world, and its continuing expansion. Current costs are circling, hovering around $100 billion. So Clock Tower, the Ajaad Fortress, a 18th century Ottoman structure, was destroyed to build this structure here. And at the top of the building, we've got the four-faced clock, which can be seen from 25 kilometers away. And each of these clock face measures 43 meters. And it is illuminated by 2 million LED lights. Just the four faces of the clock are covered with 98 million pieces of glass mosaics. So if we look just in Mecca, 601 meters. Then Abraj Al Bayt, Hajar Tower, Maqam Tower, Qibla Tower, Safa Tower, Marwa Tower, all hovering around 232 meters, which is about plus minus between 40 and 45 floors. And then Wa antara al hufat urat, when you see these shepherds of the desert, these ordinary simpletons vying for high-rise structures. So one was we did what the tunnels, one was Makkah al Mukarramah, the buildings will surpass the mountains. And then in the world, the highest of towers where people will boast about it. Number one ranked in the world is the Burj Khalifa, which is 828 meters high and 163 floors. Just to wash the 24,348 windows, it takes 36 workers around 4 months just to clean the exterior. That's around 120,000 square meters. Just the steel use was around 55,000 tons. And it took construction 22 million man hours. Outside the Khalifa is the Dubai Fountain. Just on the fountain alone, $217 million was spent. So we see now at the moment there's the race for tall structures. Let's go into the future. Number one ranked will be the Nakheel Tower in Dubai, UAE, at a height of 1,410 meters, forecasted to be 200 floors. Then secondly, Saudi Arabia, Jeddah, the Jeddah Tower, 1,008 meters high, 168 floors, forecasted to be concluded in 2024. Then the Burj Mubarak Al Kabir, which is in Kuwait, 1,001 meters, 234 floors, to be concluded in 2030. So Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam has warned us, and we see in the Middle East this challenge is out and people are vying with each other. These are signs and we need to prepare. The amal for today is, if a female reads her salat on time, protects her private parts, obeys her husband, دَخَلَتْ مِنْ أَيِّ أَبْوَابِ الْجَنَّةِ شَاءَ, she will enter in Jannah from whichever door she desires. May Allah give us tawfiq of making amal, wa akhiru da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.